Alright, fellas, hello, welcome back to the channel. So, in today's video, I'm going to show you something different and something that I think you're pretty much not going to find anywhere in terms of Resident Evil Resistance content on YouTube. And there is something called Immortal Yorick build. It's not as much of a build rather than a gameplay strategy for area. But this is a thing that works pretty much in all areas. I'm not really a believer of area-specific builds in this game as Mastermind. But starting off with equipment here, you can use the basic idea is to have as much health as possible and fortifying virus at least level 2 or level 3. This is the deck that I'll be showing, although there will be a couple of games in which I'm showing a different deck. I'm using only two sets of vapors, and I'm using also like creatures that have innate poison, or I'm not using the infectious mode, but rather the 3 and 5 cost creatures that have already poison on them. If you have 3 vapors in your deck will become too clogged with vapors, and eventually you're gonna run out of energy. And the main thing here is to use the healing vapor in area 2. The other passives are of course increased creature HP and the creature defense through buffs. So the idea is to have as much HP and tankiness as possible for your creatures and have regeneration in order to be able to tank damage in area 2 for Yorick, of course. So starting off again with my preset creatures, it's an infection zombie. I'm trying to use the emote to just duck beneath the obstacle here. Uptown is overall a better map for creature-based masterminds compared to Downtown, in my opinion. Although Area 3 for Uptown is still very unfavorable. Here I wasn't able to defend the door very well. But now I have a tough zombie with one buff and almost max HP and regeneration. Regeneration actually, it's not something that is very, I would say, easy and instinctive to understand, but when you have regen and when you have increased HP, you actually save energy on your encounters, okay? You save energy because you just have more creatures that are on the map that are sustainable, and at some points the survivors are going to realize that taking on the creatures takes too many resources from them, and they're going to start and just pass by the creatures. And if you place them, and when you have the preset with the devices and the keys set in a way that is made to have multiple encounters for the survivors, that's when you can use creatures that are buffed but have been down for a while multiple times, because you just get them on full health after the regeneration in like 10 or 15 seconds. So regeneration is very good and very underrated buff in my opinion. And the reason that I'm not using a infectious vapor in this case is, like I said, because you can use the creatures, you can either use the creatures with innate infections like the 3 and 5 cost creatures, or you can just add in The infectious mold that allows the creatures to be infectious as they spawn, and then just use a kind of like a cheaper version of the creatures in order for you to not run out of bioenergy. Here I'm not gonna use the ivy. Here I'm gonna save it for area 2, because with the strategy and execution that I'm planning, I'm going to put a lot of pressure on them and emphasis on area 2 because of the healing vapor. The healing vapor gives a lot more sustenance for your creature builds, especially when you're running high HP and fortifying virus. So it's something that can be used. I'm going to use the ivy here in this room because they'll eventually have to go there. Now, initially when you rotate into the healing vapor in area 2, you won't be able to use it right away. The point of these creatures in these starting locations is to just spread infection, although I don't have equipment for infection. When every single encounter is with infectious creatures, they will eventually get, if you guard the doors correctly, and if they have to disengage at some point, your regeneration will regain back HP for your creature. So here I'm gonna use the healing vapor, and all of the creatures that were alive or low on HP will be able to fight again. Here I'm up against the hot dogger from Jill, and as you can see, creature HP, or it's rare called creature skin 1-2-3 plus fortifying virus 3 gives a lot of tankiness to this zombie. Jill of course is using a melee build, that's why she has a hot dogger, because it scales with her her melee attacks. But here comes the important part, okay? So the general strategy and the general thing that you need to do in area 3 when you are using the healing vapor is the following, okay? So after the first couple of encounters, when they have to face Yorick, you need to have rotated your deck in order to have the healing vapor ready to go and have some expense of bioenergy. So here you can see Val is shooting at Yorick, and I'm going to heal him for over 3000 HP, and now he's full HP. Now the ideal situation is to have the healing vapor in your rotation, control Yorick with the fortifying virus level 3, and just tank a lot of damage with him, fight as hard as you can, and mitigate a lot of damage. Here I wasn't able to execute this exactly perfect, but he's still alive and he has the regeneration on him, so that's good. But the ideal situation is to control him initially after he has all the buffs for defense and the regeneration, of course. Okay, I was able to chase them out. Then after you fight with him for some period of time, you eventually release control. You need to fight near doors to be able to do this properly. You eventually release control, then after you have rotated into the healing vapor, you use the healing vapor to heal him back to full HP, then spawn a couple of other creatures before the cooldown for your controlling the creature runs out, then go back to control Yorick and basically restart the situation again. So as you can see with fortifying virus level 3 with all the heals that I was able to get, and against Jill with melee build and hot dogger, and I was able to keep Yorick alive for a very long period of time, draining their resources, and at the end they weren't even able to kill him. So that is something that can be useful, and you should definitely try it for sure. Like I said, regeneration is a must when you're running builds like this. The disadvantage is, of course, that when you don't have infectious vapor, Yorick is not infectious, so that's a bit of a downside. But like I said, if you have too many vapors in your deck, it will eventually become a problem for your rotation, especially in area 3 if you're running the mixed enhancer. But the crucial part is, once again, to have the healing vapor on deck, control Yorick, fight, and tank a lot of damage. Then when you're near the door, just go on the other side of the door if possible, close it, release control, use the healing vapor to heal at full HP, and then control him again to just basically reset the situation, and that way you can put a lot, and I mean a lot of pressure on them, draining their resources and being able to waste a lot of time in area 2. And after they eventually get past area 2, in area 3 the healing vapor combined with the fact that you have the mixer there in area 3, and in the best case scenario you have a lot of creatures, that healing vapor gives you again a lot of sustenance for your creatures, and like I said earlier, it actually saves energy because you have creatures on the map that are alive on full HP, and you don't actually need to spawn new creatures, okay? Now, of course, there are counters to this, and if you have like Martin with the flash that removes the buffs and all the other options that they have to also remove buffs with headshots and stuff like that for Becca and Valerie, you're not always going to have buffs that give you increased defense. But when you have equipment with high HP and high sustain with Fortifying Virus, there is no real counter to Fortifying Virus. They just have to damage the creatures a lot in order to be able to defeat them. And when you have a lot of tough creatures and they are spread out strategically across the map in order for the survivors to have to face them multiple times, it can be used. It's a little bit tricky and maybe counterintuitive that you don't actually aim at spawning a lot of creatures, but rather keep creatures that are already from your preset on or from initial spawns alive for a longer period of time. It's a little bit hard to exactly evaluate in which situation you need to spawn creatures and which situation you need to just be patient and use your existing creatures. That's why in some cases I'm also using decks with quick draw, because if I want to do something else, I use the quick draw to get new cards and then just spawn a new creature, or just add one more buff before engaging with them. So here they will be able to... I'm using the dealer experimentally because I want to be able to further drain their resources by doing the dealer slash and with all the like sustains for the other creatures. Ideally, I would like for them to run out of resources just before getting to area 3. By the way, when creatures got shot in the legs, yes, they can, with the regen, they can recover their limbs, but it really takes a lot of time. And I wasn't really able to find any like solution, concrete solution to that part of the problem. You just have to you have to fight for every door, and you have to fight hard on every encounter and not allow them to just get a clear vision and shoot you indiscriminately. So on the downtown area 2, this is a very important point to defend. It's this corridor here, and as you'll be able to see, I am still keeping the healing vapor on deck. Here I'm just gonna get out and start trying to harass them. I was able to tank a one hit, but here I'm gonna just heal the creatures. So this dock is part of the preset. This is a preset that is specific for tough creatures and a lot of sustain. So yeah, I didn't have any buffs maybe on this creature, therefore he fell very easily. But here, by the way, in this room, you can create a additional like ambush position, and even if Yorick is not here and they start moving past this room, you can have a couple of creatures in that room, then just open the door and attack them and try to split them and attack them from behind. That's going to be ideal. Here I just missed the Dira Slash, and I'm probably too over-focused on having the map on display in every single encounter. That isn't something that you should do every single time. But here in this encounter, I actually run out of energy. I'm still having the healing vapor on deck, and I'm going to try to do something different. I probably should have stayed in control of Yorick during that encounter. I'm gonna heal him, and here he's on full HP and the fight starts. But unfortunately, now he doesn't have the regeneration because he got flashed, unfortunately. So maybe when you're up against Martin, you need to just prepare for that and have all the other vapors in your rotation as well. But as you can see, with level 3 fortifying virus, you really can tank a lot of damage. I also think that in this room, you can probably use the choke point in the corner, the one that survivors are using, to get Yorick there and fight one on one. Okay, so here I'm going to release control, put in the regeneration vapor, then put the other vapor, and then yeah, here I got delayed, unfortunately. That room is very hard to navigate and control, but they used up a lot of resources in this encounter, and Yorick is still alive. And they'll have to re-engage now, and I have again the healing vapor on deck. I healed him to full HP, and I'm taking control once again, and now the situation is reset. And here the Ivy is doing work, and they just weren't able to kill him once again. And in those two games that I just show you, the couple of the survivors in those games are actually good players. That guy, shout outs to Bilchun if he's watching right now. He's one of the better Jill survivors out there. In the previous game, I played against a duo, actually, that two guys hooked on Yui and hooked on Nier, always playing a duo. So yeah, fortifying virus level 3 with all the creature skins is not the best in terms of overall your equipment usage, because it's 21, not 25, but you can use different configurations. Although I personally have found that fortifying virus level 3 is very good. In the previous iterations of the game, when the limit was 20, you could only use fortifying virus level 2 and the creature skin 1, 2, 3. But now you can go to level 3, and that's really good. And in the last piece of gameplay commentary and just demonstration of this concept, I'm actually going to just straight up show you the encounter of this game in Area 2, because it was just hilarious what happened. And as you can see, even regular zombies, when they have creature skin 1, 2 and 3 and 2 vapors for defense on them, they can tank a lot of damage. So here I didn't move Yorick from this location because I wanted him to be defended with creatures on both sides. But as now I have the two defense buffs, I'm just gonna go and straight up try to attack them. As I was able to see, Martin didn't have his buff removing flash, so yeah, they're shooting him with the shotgun, but he's still alive. And here, as you can see, I released control, I used the healing vapor, then spawned a couple creatures and got back in controlling Yorick again, and pretty much it's a reset situation for them. Now they have to fight him all over again, and poor Yorick doesn't have a lot of meat left on his bones, but he's still going because he's pretty much immortal, or at least this is the way they see him. And here Jan got desperate and just quit the game, then Becca quit the game, and they're still shooting him, and he's still alive, and like his legs are almost like sticks. It looks hilarious. So yeah guys, this is the way to keep Yorick alive in Area 2 for longer periods of time. Of course, the Berserk Aura zombie and the Zero Cost basic zombie are also very good. And of course the Triple Dogs if you're running Epsilon, but the Healing Vapor shouldn't be underestimated, and if used properly, it can really benefit you not only in Area 2 but also in Area 3 when they eventually get there, and even in Area 3s where there are no doors and there are these wide open areas in which good survivors can shoot creatures from afar without any serious risk. The Healing Vapor can help keep your creatures alive and keep your bioenergy expenses low. Okay guys, this is going to be it for this video. Thanks for watching. I hope you like it, and please don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!